at the beginning, I was alone, and nobody knows about Malpelo. Since 2000, we are doing monitoring around Malpelo. We invite different scientists who work in different topics, ichthyoplankton in oceanography, birds, corals, and marine invertebrates. And like this, we can have year by year information about how are the ecosystem and the population of different species. With this information, institutions of the government can take measures to protect species and ecosystems. Malpelo was increased and now is a no-take zone, 47,000 kilometers square, very big. Since 2000, we have information at least 2 times per year on the trends of different species. We have a lot of species who are increasing the population. For example, a lot of groupers and snappers are in very good shape.
Oh, 3,000. Oh, yes, it's very big.
But for a lot of sharks, like hammerhead sharks, like silky sharks, they are going down.
Combien de requins marteau?
Deux.
These animals not only stay around the marine protected area, they cross the marine frontiers of Colombia and they go also to other countries. But with time, I understand we cannot only protect one island. And so we need a lot of people working in different places of the world. To be part of Mission Blue with the support of Rolex is very important. The more we are working together, we can share our information. And like this, we can understand the connectivity and the movement of all these endangered species around Eastern Tropical Pacific.
See, we have a shark who was tagged with the acoustic tags.
So we work together with other hotspot champions, for example, Hector Guzman in Cordillera de Coiba, Panama, with Randall Arauz in Costa Rica with Cocos, James Ketchum in Mexico, and Alice Hearn in Galapagos.
So that one, 22687, is something that came from Malpelo. That one's exciting.
We will continue to work all together to try to have a better ocean.